Damn it. Not again. I need my laptop. Oh, I need a bigger screen. Just in time. When it comes to choosing the right monitor, it's not just about having the biggest screen or the highest resolution. You need to think about a few key factors that suit your needs and lifestyle. First and foremost, it's always budget and size. Each of these displays tend to fall into a price segment. For example, if you're looking for something under SGD 300, you're probably looking at a basic 24-inch display. Move up to the SGD 500 bracket, and then you have your 27-inch 1440p screens, such as BenQ's 27-inch programming monitor. Then as you go even higher, you access displays such as this RD320U. Then you have size and workspace ergonomics. Does your setup allow effective use of the display size you want? How far away from the display will you be sitting? The ideal viewing distance for a 27-inch monitor is at least 60 cm, but for this 32-inch, it's at least 70 cm, so you'll want a deeper desk, at least 70 to 80 cm to maintain comfort. This desk is actually only 60 cm. I ended up sitting with my keyboard very close to the edge in order to sit further back for a more comfortable viewing distance. Other things that could help would perhaps be putting the display on an arm or even wall mounting it to gain back some of that viewing distance. And finally, it's the hero feature. Every monitor has a hero feature aimed at a specific target audience. For example, if you're a serious content creator, you might be looking at the BenQ Designer series for top-notch color accuracy. For gamers, you could be looking at the Zowie lineup, which boasts higher refresh rates and superior motion clarity, but perhaps lower resolutions at the same screen sizes for the best gaming performance. And if you spend most of your day or night coding and writing, then you have this programming RD series, with the color modes that cater to the best screen environment for work, and eye care features that work seamlessly in the background, taking care of you automatically. So the question is, what do you do most, and what's most important to you in a monitor? This is the BenQ RD320U. It's a 32-inch 4K display, part of BenQ's programming series monitors. Packed with a full suite of eye care features, it's designed to provide developers with the best working experience. This is a similar setup to the RD280U I reviewed a few months back, the biggest difference being the aspect ratio and size. Here, we have a more conventional 16:9 32-inch display. On the exterior, the RD320U comes with the same neat little attention to details. You have the same great pivot stand, with the height markings for those who want to readjust the monitor to the same exact position. You also still have the neat little ladder-like cable clip to put all the cables together at the back. Even on the box, there's a flap that highlights the key features even as you unbox the monitor. The RD320U has the Moon Halo ambient backlighting, which you can set both brightness and warmness of the light to your own preference. You also get the function bar with the controls and coding hotkey. Connectivity-wise, we have the same layout. DisplayPort 1.4, HDMI 2.0, USB-C with 90 watts power delivery, and a downstream USB-C port for a daisy chain display. And on the bottom of the monitor, for peripherals and the built-in KVM, two USB-A ports, a USB-C port, and an audio jack. I have a few top favorite features of this display. The first is the coding hotkey button. Switching between using a light background editor when I'm working on documents, to dark background editors when I'm working on code or in terminal, or just switching to my regular MBook color mode, everything is easily done with a quick tap of the button on this function bar. Automated night hours protection is back as well. This is still my most favorite eye care feature of this series of monitors. Once I set a preferred brightness level under normal bright environments, and the level of night hours protection I prefer, I leave it to the monitor to dim accordingly. Much better than toggling with the brightness setting constantly on a regular monitor. Contrast ratio is also a lot higher on this display. At 2000 to 1, blacks are a lot deeper. This also means that this display is great for consuming content. This works out extra well for me because this workspace actually sits in the living room of my house. We don't have a TV, so this display also functions as the display for movie nights. Just remember to switch the color mode for the best experience. There is also dual view, which is really useful when you're working with different content on screen. It's possible to have a Photoshop window in the proper color mode and your editor in coding dark theme mode at the same time. The single cable docking with power delivery is also very handy. And the built-in KVM continues to be a favorite as well, although cable management can get a little messy with a wired keyboard and mouse. Switching over to a PC to play some games is still super convenient. Another cool feature is PIP-PBP, picture by picture or picture in picture, basically displaying multiple sources simultaneously. This works great, especially if your job or workflow requires you to use two separate computers. In my case, I often have both the MacBook as well as a work laptop running at the same time. This is pretty useful if you need to closely reference information, especially if it is accessible only within secure work laptops, or if you're testing software on a different OS platform. Lastly, with the newer Display Pilot 2 software, there's a new feature called Flow. Flow is similar to circadian mode, the automatic night shift mode that turns up the low blue light filter after sunset. But Flow is like the overpowered big brother to circadian. Going beyond just low blue light settings, you can now tweak everything on a schedule, from color modes to audio settings to the moon halo and more. Honestly, with the coding hotkey, it is already super convenient for me to change color modes on the fly depending on the activity. So I tried to do something else with it, creating partitions throughout a typical workday to help me get into the appropriate mind space for each activity. For example, I set up a focus max scene with a brighter screen and less blue light filtering in the morning from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. as the day starts, helping me to get into the zone. From 10 to 3, I dim it down as I get into the daily work grind. From 3 to 6, it brightens up again, switching to a brighter color mode to help me get through that afternoon fatigue. And finally at 6 p.m, color mode automatically switches to game mode and the warm moon halo comes on, reminding me to start winding off work. And at 11 p.m, the low blue light filter maxes out as I start to switch up to a more restful mind space to prepare for bed. Although, a lot of times I do still end up ignoring this and continuing the entertainment. Between these application-specific color modes and the seamless schedule switching, the RD320U really starts to feel like a next-generation monitor that takes care of you automatically. Overall, I really like the RD320U. The more conventional 16:9 aspect ratio and the higher contrast ratios means it performs even better for the entertainment part of my day. And whether it's early in the morning or late at night when it comes to productivity, I really like that my eye care needs are automated. So I just dock my MacBook in and quickly get my work done, without having to overthink the process. No need to fiddle with the brightness settings manually. Which means no unnecessary eye strain, because honestly, I'm always too lazy to reach out and dim a monitor even when it's too bright. If you're in the market for a 32-inch display, you should definitely check this one out. That's all for today. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.